Sometimes you meet a person and everything changes. Has it happened to you? It happened to author Jay Shetty. And who was that person? That person was Sri Gaurang Gadas, an IIT Bombay graduate who left everything to become a monk. Would you ever think such things? No, right? That is the obvious answer. Why did he do that? That is something that drew Jay to him. He was mesmerized by the thing that someone can leave IIT Bombay, which is MIT of India, and to become a monk. Would you do this? Suppose you get this choice. Choice one is to become a monk. Choice two, to get a high salary job after graduating from IIT Bombay. What would you choose? Obviously this one, right? No doubt about it. But if someone chooses this, then obviously he's crazy, isn't it? No. See, why do you choose this and not this? Because you are getting satisfaction here, right? Your bills are getting paid, your family problems will be get solved, right? Or you have worked hard for this. How can you choose this now, right? So that is the obvious choice, right? But suppose whatever you were chasing is not giving you satisfaction and suddenly you find that this will give you satisfaction, then what will you choose? You have studied and become IIT graduate, that's okay. But this is not something which will give you fulfillment, but this will give you fulfillment. Now what will you choose? Obviously something which gives you fulfillment. Then that is the thing that Sri Gauranga Das might have seen, something which is not here but it is here. That's why he left everything and became a monk, right? So that is something that Jay was mesmerized and he wanted to know. What is that something that he left this and became this? And he was drawn to him. And he fell in love in the first lecture that Sri Gauranga Das gave. And there is a Hindi Bollywood song which describes this phenomenon completely. That is, Shama kahe parwane se pare chala ja, meri tarha jal jayega, paas nahi yaar. Wo nahi sunta, usko jal jana hota hai. The insects are drawn to light. Why? Because they see something fantastic. There's something which appeals to their life. Though they will end their life, but they still want to live that. And that's what Jay was finding. And obviously he got that and he wrote this book. So we'll be sharing what Jay experienced in those years at the ashram. He became a monk for 3 years and whatever he experienced, he has shared this in this book, and we'll be sharing that with you. So there is one simple incident that he narrates and this will blow your mind. When Jay was becoming a monk, it was just his first day. And in the first day, what did he see? He saw that some people were gathered, like some 10 to 12 kids were there. And one kid was what age? A 10 year old boy was teaching them. So he asked, what are you teaching them? Well, this is their first class. So he asked, what are you teaching them then? What do you teach children in first class? Obviously ABCD, obviously I learned ABCD, right? But he was teaching them breath, how to control breath, how to manage breath. Then Jay asked, why this? Well, the breath is something which is associated with you from the beginning of life and it will end it will be there till the end of your life, right? Something which is since your birth and it will go with your life. How you cannot manage that? That is the basic thing, that is the phenomena, that is the essential thing, right? That blew my mind, that blew Jay's mind too. So that's what so this is the this book gives you the way of life, how we are going to discuss about how to let go of internal obstacles that are holding us back. Okay, then we will help in second part. We will see how we can grow ourselves, how we can reshape our life, and how we can transform. And in the third part, we will see that how we can look beyond ourselves, how by serving people, how by gratitude, by sense of gratitude, we can live a more fulfilled life. So that's all for this video. We'll meet you in the next video in the chapter 1, that is negativity. Thank you so much.